Welcome back students, we are in introduction to word processor. In that we are discussing OpenOffice Writer. So in the previous class we have dealt with how to open, how to type, what are the shortcut keys, everything we have discussed. Then how to open an already existing document, how to save it, how to close it, everything we have discussed in the previous class. So in this class what we are going to see is how to edit a document. We are going to see how to edit. What do you mean by edit? What do you mean by edit? For example, while you are typing, you are having some spelling mistakes, or you have to insert some text, or you have to insert a character or a letter or a word. That similarly you people can do cut, copy, paste, move, that and all you people are going to discuss under editing a document. Okay, ma? First we can see corrections, how to do the corrections. So there are two different ways to do the correction. First we are going to see how to do the corrections. So here you are having two ways. The first one, it is by using the backspace key. Backspace key, first one, it is you can do the correction by using the backspace key. Here what it is actually happening, for example, people consider your cursor is here, just you are clicking the backspace means it will be moving in this direction, it will be moving in this direction for you. So here that it deletes the character left of the insertion pointer. Backspace means deletes the character left of the insertion pointer. Insertion pointer. This is your backspace key. Next we are going to have the next key. It is your delete key. Next we are going to discuss the delete key. What is the delete key is going to do for you? Yes, it is going to delete the character right of the insertion pointer. It is going to delete the character right of the insertion pointer. So by now we have discussed how to correct by means of two different ways. What are they? By using your backspace key, and another one is by using your delete key. Next we are going to see how to insert a text. For that, what do you people have to do? Yes, you have to press the insert key. Where you people have to have your text, keep your cursor there and press the insert key. For example, you people see here A, B, C, D, E. I am willing to insert here. Then I have to keep my insertion pointer here. Then I have to keep my insertion pointer here. So I have to hear what I have to do. I have to click the insert key. Just by clicking the insert key, what it will be? Then you people can start typing. What else you people willing to type, you people can type it there. So this is the one of the way how you people can insert a text. So this is in your insert mode. Another mode you people are having, it is your type over mode. So the first, it is your insert mode. How you are going to insert? The first one we have discussed by now is it's your insert mode, and the next you people are having, it is your type over mode. What do you mean by type over? So already irukkira text ku mele nee enna pannirlaan, type panikite poite irukalam. For example, naanga A, B, C, D, E ezhudirkenla, so I am willing to change the D into something, na just na enna pannite irukalam, type panikite irukalam. So D ku mele na type pannumbodhu enna text, for example, I am willing to have F na enna avanum, just adhula F vandrum appra E vandrum, what else na type pandrano automatically change aayite irukum. So that is your type over mode. So for this, what do you people have to do? You have to click the insert key. You have to click the insert key again. So first time நீ insert key press பண்ணிருந்தா அது என்ன மோட்ல இருக்கும்? Insert மோட்ல இருக்கும். அந்த கீயை நீ திரும்பி இன்னொரு தடவை press பண்ணனா automatically it will be moving to type over mode. Automatically it will be moving to the type over mode. So these are the two ways by which you people can insert a text in between. In between, if you people are going to insert a text or a character, that is your character means, what you have to do? You have to go on with the insert mode, that is by pressing the insert key, and the another one, it is by having your next mode, it is your type over mode. It is your type over mode. So these are the ways by which you people can insert the text. Next we are going to see how to select. Select means, for example, if you people are willing to change the font or change the font style, so before changing anything you people must select it. So before applying any formatting you must select that one. Select the text. If you people are willing to copy, move or willing to do any formatting, means before doing that one you must select the text. So the selection can be done in two methods. That is selecting the continuous text. First one, it is selecting the continuous text. What do you mean by continuous? Yes, தொடர்ந்து அந்த டெக்ஸ்ட் இருக்கும்ல அந்த மாதிரி டெக்ஸ்ட்டை நீ செலக்ட் பண்ணலாம். அனதர் ஒன், இட் இஸ் யூ ஆர் செலக்டிங் த நான் கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட். நான் கண்டினியூஸ்னா, ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட் லைனை முதல்ல செலக்ட் பண்ணுவேன், அதுக்கப்புறம் ஃபிஃப்த் லைன், அப்புறம் டென்த் லைன், லைக் தட் யூ பீப்புள் ஆர் கோயிங் டு செலக்ட் மீன்ஸ் தட் இஸ் யூர் செலக்டிங் த நான் கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட். ஃபஸ்ட் ஒன், இட் இஸ் யூர் செலக்டிங் த கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட், அண்ட் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இட் இஸ் யூர் நான் கண்டினியூஸ். கண்டினியூஸ்னால் எப்படி, தொடர்ந்து அந்த ஃபஸ்ட் லைன்லேருந்து டென்த் லைன் வர. த நான் கண்டினியூஸ் மீன்ஸ் ஃபஸ்ட் லைனு, தென் தேர்ட் லைன், தென் ஃபிஃப்த் லைன், தென் செவன்த் லைன், லைக் தட் யூ பீப்புள் ஆர் கோயிங் டு செலக்ட் மீன்ஸ் தட் இஸ் யூர் செலக்டிங் த நான் கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட். ஸோ ஃபஸ்ட் வீ கேன் சி ஹவு டு செலக்ட் த கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட். ஃபஸ்ட் வீ ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி ஹவு டு செலக்ட் த கண்டினியூஸ் டெக்ஸ்ட். எப்படி செலக்ட் பண்ணலாம்? எஸ், பை யூசிங் யுவர் மவுஸ் பாயிண்டர். வாட் யூ பீப்புள் ஹவ் டு டூ? ஃபஸ்ட் யூ ஹவ் டு கிளிக் த ஷிஃப்ட் கீ, ஷிஃப்ட் பிளஸ் drag the mouse pointer. Next you have to drag the mouse pointer till how much, which line you people need, until that you have to drag it. It's okay, I have selected everything means release the shift key. Then you people release the shift key, that area will be selected for you. How you people can recognize that it is selected? Yes, that text alone will be in blue color for you. That is whole area selected will be in selected way for you. So the next you people are going to select the non-continuous text. For that, how you people have to go on? Yes, for that you have to go on with the control key. Control plus, as usual, you have to drag across the line in which you people are willing to have. Just you people have to click the control and you have to go on with a space or go on with the lines or paragraphs. What else you people need for this? You have to go on with in which, just by clicking the control. Continuous means press the shift key, non-continuous means press the control key. Okay, wow. So then selection can be done in different ways. By using your mouse also you can do the selection, and the next selection you people can do it by using your keyboard also. First selection can be done in two ways. Okay, wow. What are they? First one, it is by using your mouse, and the next one it is by using your keyboard. Mouse means what else? Yes, just now we have discussed, no? What you have to do? First, you must have the insertion pointer at the beginning. You have to have the insertion pointer at the start. So, first two pointers, insertion pointer at the beginning, at the start. Okay, wow. And next step, what do you people have to do? Yes, hold the left mouse button and drag. Hold left mouse button next and drag it. Okay, wow. So it is by using your mouse, then the selected text will be highlighted for you. The text, selected text will be highlighted. So this is the way how you people can select it by using the mouse. You have the insertion point at the starting point, then hold the left mouse button and drag it, and the last thing will be the selected text will be highlighted for you. And the next way is by using your keyboard. The first step, as usual, have your insertion pointer at the starting, in which, from which line you people need or from which word you need, from that you have it. That is your insertion point at the starter. Next, to hold the shift key, Next to hold the shift key plus the movement keys. What are the movement keys? You can have this side arrow or this side arrow or up arrow or down arrow, like that you will be having, no? So these keys are called as your movement keys. From these four, you people can select any one. So the selected text will be highlighted. So the selected text will be highlighted for you. So these are the two ways by which you people can select the text. Similarly, you are having another one way, that is selected by using your shortcut keys. Selection by using your shortcut keys. To select the whole document, yes, you have to press Ctrl plus A. To select the whole document, you have to click Ctrl plus A. If you are going to select a word, what you have to do? Double click on the word. Double click on the word. Okay, wow. So these are the ways. First one, it is by using your mouse, and the next one, it is by using your keyboard, and the next by using your shortcut keys. To select the whole document, you have to go on with Ctrl plus A, and the next one, to have a single word, means you have to double click on that word. Okay, wow. Then that word will be selected for you. So these are the ways how you people can select. The first, it is your selecting the continuous text. Next, selecting the non-continuous text. Then selection can be done in two ways, that is by using your mouse, another by using your keyboard. Mouse also we have discussed, keyboard also we have discussed. Next one, it is by using your shortcut keys. To select the whole document, press Ctrl A, or if you are going to have a word, double click on the word. So clear with the procedure or way how to do the selecting the text. Yes, next we are going to see moving and copying. Next we are going to see about moving and copying a text. What do you mean by move and what do you mean by copying? Moving means, yes, going from one place to another. That is your moving. Copying means, so it will be seen in the first place and also it will be seen in the second place. For example, you people have a single document, okay, wow. So it is called as your source and it is your destination, okay, wow. So you are having the first document, let the name be S1. Yes, now you are going to do the move. Move means this S1 will be seen only in destination alone. So this is your move. After moving, it will not seen in the source. So what is copy for you? Yes, the source, this will be here also, and here also you will be having that one. So S1 is your simple document name, okay, why? It is your sample one. So source, before moving, you are having the source, the name is S1. After performing the move operation, it is seen only in the destination alone. But after having the copy, it will be seen in the source as well as in the destination. So this is the difference between move and the copy. It is the difference between the move and the copy. So first we can see what are the steps to move a document, steps to move a text. First we can see move a text. It is applied for the document also. Okay, well, first we can see how to move a text. So you people know, before doing any formatting, editing operation, what do you have to do? You must select the text. So here the first step is select text. First you are going to select the text which is to be moved for you. Okay, wow. Then what do you have to do? Here you are just moving. Next step, you have to go on with Ctrl plus X. The shortcut key you are going to use is Ctrl plus X, or you have to go on with edit, cut, or you have to go on with cut icon, which is available in the toolbar for you. You have to go on with a cut icon. Just click that one, automatically it will be removed in the source for you. Then you move on to the destination where you need that line. Have your insertion pointer there. There you people press Ctrl plus V. You have to go on with Ctrl plus V or edit, paste, or paste icon, or you can have the paste icon. So these are the steps that you have to follow to move the text from one source to the destination. Next we are going to see how to copy a text. So before doing anything, you must select the text. Here select the text. Many ways are having, no? By using any of the simple way, you people select the text. Next, you people are going to copy it. For that, what do you have to do? Yes, you have to go on with Control plus C or Edit, Copy, or you will be having your copy icon, or you will be having your copy icon. Okay, well, have a glance over it. Next, what will be happening? So what else you have copied, everything will be placed on the clipboard for you. The duplicate copy will be placed on the clipboard. So in between you will be having a clipboard. Here what else you have copied, that will be stored in the clipboard. Okay, wow. So after that, what do you people have to do? You have to take the insertion pointer to the location where you need the text to be copied. Ni endha edathla paste pandra virumbriyo, copy panna virumbriyo, andha edathla unoda insertion pointer kondu poi vachittu next ni enna cheyanum? Control plus V, or you have to go on with Edit, Paste, or what do you have to do? You have to go on with the paste icon. Clear with this one? So these are the procedures that you people have to follow for cut, copy, paste. Okay, wow. So that is to for moving and copying a document, text or a document. These are the steps that you people have to follow. So clear with the steps. What else we have discussed by now? So what do you people able to know the difference between what is a move and what is a copy? So while having this concept itself, we have discussed the shortcut keys also for cut, copy, paste. Similarly, here you are having another one shortcut key. It is your undo. For undo, the shortcut key is Control plus Z. What do you mean by undo? For example, to stop that action, to have your previous, அதாவது நீ தெரியாமல் ஏதாவது கிளிக் பண்ணிவிட்டேன், தப்பான எதுவும் பண்ணிவிட்டேன், எனக்கு அது வேண்டாம், நான் பழசாக பண்ணதான் எனக்கு வேணும் அப்படின்னு நினச்சேன்னா, ஜஸ்ட் யூ கோ ஆன் வித் கண்ட்ரோல் பிளஸ் இசட். ஸோ இட் வில் அன்டூ இட் ஃபார் யூ. ஸோ கிளியர் வித் திஸ் ஒன். ஸோ அண்டர் பேஸ்ட் இட் செல்ஃப் யூ ஆர் ஹேவிங் அனதர் ஒன், தட் இஸ் யுவர் பேஸ்ட் ஸ்பெஷல். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சி இஸ் யுவர் பேஸ்ட் ஸ்பெஷல். ஸோ பை த நேம் இட் செல்ஃப் இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பேஸ்ட் சம்திங், பட் இட் இஸ் சம் வாட் டிஃப்ரெண்ட். தட் இஸ் இட் இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி அ ஸ்பெஷல் ஃபார் யூ. வாட் இட் இஸ், எஸ் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள், இஃப் யூ பீப்புள் ஆர் வில்லிங் டு ஹாவ் த ஃபாண்ட், அதாவது இந்த டெக்ஸ்டில் நான் என்ன ஃபாண்ட் வச்சுருக்கணும் அதே தான் இன்னொரு டாக்குமெண்ட்டில் எனக்கு இந்த ஃபாண்ட் வேணும் அப்படின்னா நீ என்ன பண்ணிக்கலாம், அதை பேஸ்ட் பண்ணிக்கலாம். அப்படி இல்லைனா நீ என்ன செய்யலாம், வேறு ஏதாவது ஃபார்மேட்டிங், இல்லை இங்கே ஒரு இடத்துல நான் கால்குலேஷன் பண்ணி அதோட ரிசல்ட் எனக்கு வேறு ஒரு டாக்குமெண்ட்டில் வேணும், வேறு ஒரு ஃபைலில் வேணும்னா நீ என்ன பண்ணிக்கலாம், யூ கேன் கோ ஆன் வித் திஸ் ஆப்ஷன், தட் இஸ் யுவர் பேஸ்ட் ஸ்பெஷல். ஃபார் தட் வாட் யூ பீப்புள் ஹவ் டு டூ, யூ ஹவ் டு செலக்ட் த டெக்ஸ்ட். எல்லாம் செய்கிறக்கு முன்னாடி என்ன பண்ணிக்கணும், மறந்துடாத, டோன்ட் ஃபார்கெட், யூ ஹவ் டு செலக்ட் த டெக்ஸ்ட். ஆஃப்டர் தட் வாட் யூ ஹவ் டு டூ, யூ ஹவ் டு கிளிக் எடிட் பேஸ்ட் ஸ்பெஷல். You have to click Edit, Paste, Special. Otherwise, you are having the shortcut key. It is your Control plus Shift plus V. Otherwise, you are having another one. It is your Alt plus E plus S. So, these are the three shortcut ways that you people can have your shortcut. That is your Paste Special window. So after performing in these three, any one, your Paste Special dialog box will be displayed for you. Okay, wow. Paste Special dialog box will be displayed. From here, you have to select DDE. Here you are going to select DDE. What do you mean by DDE? Yes, it is nothing but you are going to exchange the data, no? So it is nothing but it is your dynamic data exchange. It is nothing but dynamic data exchange. What do you mean by dynamic data exchange? Yes, here it is a mechanism வாட் எல்ஸ், அதாவது நீ பேஸ்ட் பண்ண பிறகு இந்த அதாவது உன்னோட ஒரிஜினல் சோர்ஸ் டாக்குமெண்ட்டில் நீ என்ன என்ன சேஞ்சஸ் பண்ணாலும் தேட் வில் பி ரிஃப்ளெக்டட் இன் த, நீ எந்த இடத்துல பேஸ்ட் பண்ணியிருப்பேன்ல அந்த இடத்துல தட் வேல்யூ வில் பி ரிஃப்ளெக்டட் ஃபார் யூ. ஸோ நீ ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஒரு வேர்ட் டாக்குமெண்ட்டில் இருந்து நீ டிடி அதாவது பே ஸ்பெஷல் பண்ணியிருந்த அப்படின்னா வேறு எந்த இடத்துல கல்குலேஷன் பண்ணாலும் சரி இல்லை இங்கேருந்து எந்த ஃபாண்ட்டு ஃபார்மெட்டை மாற்றினாலும் சரி ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக நீ எந்த இடத்துல பேஸ்ட் பண்ணியிருக்கியோ அந்த இடத்துல என்ன ஆயிரும், ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி இட் வில் பி reflected for you. So that concept is called as your DDE, that is your dynamic data exchange. இந்த இது செலக்ட் பண்ண பிறகு என்ன அப்ளிகேஷன் வேணுமோ அதை செலக்ட் பண்ணிடு, then you have to go on with press OK, then you have to click the OK button. இது ஒரு லிங்க் மாதிரி உனக்கு என்ன ஆயிரும், ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்காக நீ எந்த இடத்துல பேஸ்ட் பண்ணணுமோ பேஸ்ட் பண்ணிடலாம். So this is the concept with paste special. So clear with a paste special. Yes, next we are going to discuss help. So few concepts you are unable to know, unable to proceed means you can just by clicking the F1 key, you can have the help menu or you can have the help from the menu bar, from the menu bar. In the menu bar already we have discussed, no? From the menu bar you people can select the help menu. By that help will be help window will be displayed for you. From that you people can select it. There also you are having one help agent. To activate it you have to click tools, options, open office. So by activating this one our help agent will be displayed for you. Similarly we have discussed the toolbars, no? That is your everything will be displayed like icon, I told you, no? So near that icon, if you are going to have your mouse pointer means automatically a tool tip will be displayed for you. The tool tip will tell what the icon is and the tool tip la enna irum or message display agum. So adha paathal nee kandupidichikalam mela irukra icon ennadu save na keela save ngiradhu enna agum, it will be displayed for you. So clear with this one. So just now we have finished all the editing keela nama enna laam paathom, how to select continuous ah eppadi pannanum, non continuous eppadi pannanum, ways that is by using your mouse or by using your keyboard adellam discuss pannom. Appra cut copy, that is your move copy paathom, adila cut copy paste kulla shortcut keys paathom, undo kulla adu paathom. Next we discussed the paste special and finally we discussed the help. So these are the topics that we have discussed under editing. Okay va, next we are going to continue with the next one. It is your Tamil typing interface. So already we have discussed word processor is also available for your Tamil language also. So by today or by now we are going to have the Tamil typing interface. Okay va, so you people have type everything in Tamil English. For that also we are having many word processor that we have discussed in the introduction class itself. So in this class we are going to discuss the interface alone. Okay va, yes, here typing in Tamil can be done in different methods. That is first by using your Tamil font. First you people can do it by using your Tamil font, and the next by using your Tamil interface. Next by using your interface. So font means where it will be available? Yes, it will be available in the font folder for you. From the font folder, you people have to select the Tamil font and then you people have to go on with the typing. So what else typing will be automatically changed into the Tamil letter for you. So that is your Tamil font. That is by using your Tamil font. So but this by using the Tamil font, you people are having many drawbacks. What are the drawbacks? First drawback it is drawback with Tamil font. So what are the drawback means? The first one it is user must be aware of Tamil typing. That is he must have the knowledge of Tamil typing. Knowledge of Tamil typing is a must of Tamil typing for using Tamil font. So that is the first drawback. And the next it the font, the particular font must be available. The particular font must be available in the system. Next, it does not support other languages font while you are using the Tamil font. Okay, ma'am. Not support other languages, including English also, it will not support for you, okay, va? And the next one, it does not support other languages. And the next one, it accepts characters. Computers only accept what language? It can accept and understand what language? Machine language only. But here, while you are proceeding with the Tamil font, a problem is also there also. And the next one, it is not portable. What do you mean by portable? For example, from the first computer, that is from the computer 1, I am typing in Tamil font and I am sending that message to the computer 2 means, and if the computer 2 is not having that font means, the text will not be opened clearly for you. அதாவது ஒரு டெக்ஸ்ட்டில், ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் செல்ஃபோன்லேயே நீ தமிழ்லிட்ட டைப் பண்ணிவிட்டு உன் ஃப்ரெண்டுக்கோ யாருக்கோ மெசேஜ் அனுப்புனேன்னு வச்சுக்கோ, அவங்ககிட்ட அந்த ஃபாண்ட் இருந்தால் தான் என்னாகும், ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி இட் வில் பி ஓப்பன். அதர்வைஸ் உனக்கு ஸ்மால் ஸ்மால் பாக்ஸாவோ இல்லை ஸ்மால் ஸ்மால் ரவுண்டாவோ இல்லை சிம்பிள்ஸாவோ என்னாகும், உனக்கு டிஸ்பிளே ஆகும். ஸோ தேட் இஸ் த பாயிண்ட் தேட் யூ பீப்புள் ஆர் ஹேவிங் அண்ட் நாட் portable, that is your not portable. So these are the drawbacks that are seen under Tamil font, that are the drawbacks that are under Tamil font. So to overcome these drawbacks, we are having the Tamil interface. We are having the Tamil interface. So what this interface? It is easy to type the document. So in the Tamil interface, it is having advantages. It is easy to type. First point, it is easy to type. Similarly, it is having Unicode technique. That is ASCII and all we have discussed in the second lesson, no? Here it is going to have a Unicode, that it is common to all. So by means of this, it is easy. Okay, why easy to proceed. Similarly, here many fonts also supported. Here it is also support Tamil language, English language and many languages, support other languages. But in the case of font, it will not support other languages. But while you people are using the interface, it support other languages. So these are the advantages that you people are having while you are using Tamil interface. So for the Tamil interface, you people are having an example. It is your first one, it is your Murasu. MURASU, Murasu. And the next one, it is your NMH writer. These are the two more familiar Tamil typing interface. These two are open source also. Open source means free. Open source, that it is available free on the internet for you. Similarly, you people are having the website also. For NMH writer, the website is http://software.nmhm.in. Like that you people have to type, so the writer, that is the interface, will be automatically download and later you people can install it. So what is so clear with the Tamil typing interface? So typing in Tamil can be done in different methods. What are they? By using your Tamil font, and the next one is by using your Tamil interface. So while you are proceeding with the Tamil font, there you people are having the drawback. So what is the first drawback? Yes, you must know Tamil typing. Next one is the particular font must be available in the system. அதாவது சில ஃபாண்ட்டில் தான் எனக்கு டைப் பண்ண தெரியும் நீ சொல்லுவேன், அப்போ அந்த ஃபாண்ட் என்ன பண்ணிருக்கணும், அந்த சிஸ்டமில் அவைலபிளாக இருக்கணும். ஸோ த பர்டிகுலர் ஃபாண்ட் மஸ்ட் பி அவைலபிள் இன் த சிஸ்டம். நெக்ஸ்ட், இட் டஸ் நாட் சப்போர்ட் அதர் லாங்குவேஜஸ். அண்ட் த நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், இட் அக்செப்ட்ஸ் characters. The computer accept characters as symbols and not as language. In a computer can understand only machine language and not the Tamil language or the English language. And the next one, it is not portable. Not portable means ஒரு கம்ப்யூட்டரில் இருக்கிற ஃபாண்ட் அடுத்த கம்ப்யூட்டரில் இன்ஸ்டால் ஆகிருந்தால் தான் என்ன பண்ணும், இந்த டாக்குமெண்ட் வில் பி ஓப்பன் ஃபார் யூ, அதர்வைஸ் இட் வில் நாட் சப்போர்ட். தட் இஸ் யுவர் நாட் போர்ட்டபுள். ஸோ டு ஓவர் கம் தீஸ் ட்ராபேக்ஸ், வி ஆர் ஹேவிங் த தமிழ் இன்டர்ஃபேஸ். ஸோ வாட் ஆர் த அட்வான்டேஜஸ்? ஹியர் இட் இஸ் ஈஸி டு டைப். And the next, it is going to follow the Unicode technique, and here it support other languages. It is going to support other languages also. Similarly, for this one, the example one is, yes, Murasu, and the next one, it is your NHM writer. NHM writer. So clear with the Tamil typing interface. So what else topic we have discussed by today? Editing a document. And next we have discussed, under editing we have discussed, that is your correction, okay, va? So first we have discussed editing, under that we have discussed by using backspace and delete key, okay, va? So first we have finished editing, that is backspace and And the next one, it is your by using delete key. Next, we finished how to do on with the insert key. That is your insert mode. And the next one, it is your type over mode. Insert mode. And the next one, it is your type over mode. Okay, ma. The next, we finished how to select the text. Select continuously, non-continuously. Next, what else we have discussed? Next, we finished selecting by means of different methods, that is by using your mouse, keyboard, shortcuts, discussed. The next we have discussed moving and copying. Next one, it is your moving and copy. While discussing this one itself, we have discussed the shortcut keys for cut, copy, paste. Similarly, we have finished undo. Next, we have discussed paste special. And next we finished your Tamil interface. So these are the topics that we have discussed by today. So clear with the topics, what else we have discussed by today? So clear with the OpenOffice Writer. So we have discussed in this lesson how to open a OpenOffice Writer, what are the parts of the window, that is we have discussed. Similarly, how to enter, how to edit, that is moving on the inside the document, then editing, selecting, cut, copy, paste, everything we have finished. So clear with the topics, what else we have discussed by today? Yes, reminding, we can continue the next class. Yes. Thank you, students.